Hello students, I hope all of you are doing well and safe. So today we are starting with our fourth semester and I myself, Sonia, will be handling the course name Rural Marketing Management and Market Infrastructure, which is a 2+1 credited course. And Rural Marketing Management and Market Infrastructure is a very simple and easy to understandable course. Because in the previous semesters, you have learned about marketing, principles of marketing management, and in the same course, you have learned all the aspects of marketing, the principles of marketing, the strategies, the marketing mix, all those things of marketing you have learned. So it will be very easy for you guys to understand and learn the subject, and it is a very simple subject. And this subject is very important other than your academic purpose, because we live in India, and in India more than 73% of the population lives in rural part. So being an agribusiness graduate or agribusiness pursuing student, this is very important to learn about the rural marketing. What are the strategies, what is rural marketing, why it is important, what is the scope, how it is contributing to the Indian economy, all these things we will be learning in this course. So coming back to the course rural marketing, so in the rural marketing, how does this rural marketing differs from the normal marketing or the marketing management? Yes, it is different by the term rural. So what do you mean by the term rural? What do you think the term rural means? Yes, everyone will be having different perspective towards the term or different understanding towards the term rural. So the NSSO, National Sample Survey Organization, have defined the term rural based on two aspects or two factors. First is population density based, and the other is based on the percentage of the people involved in the what kind of occupation they are involved. So based on the population density, they have defined a particular region to be rural, that will be defined as rural if the population density is up to 400 people living in a square kilometer area. In a square kilometer area, a maximum of 400 people are living, then that region will be termed as rural. Or in a region where there is no municipality or municipal bodies not present, that village will be termed as, that will be coming under the rural concept. And the other definition or the other way by which the rural is defined is if 75 or more than 75% of the male working force is involved in agriculture and allied activities, that is their main source of income is from agriculture and allied activity, then that area will be, or that region will be also called as rural. So I hope it's clear, the term rural is clear. So tell me, what is the need to enter into the rural market? Why everyone is talking about going into the rural and rural marketing aspect? Because rural India offers to the greatest hub to the Indian markets seeking growth for their production services, with 73% of the Indian population and 12% of the world population lives in Indian villages. So it's like a huge population is living in rural India, and to cater their needs and wants, the marketers have to enter into the rural area. So here lies the importance of our course, the rural marketing and the marketing infrastructure. As you know, India is a nation of diversity, where we have 32 states and 9 union territories, which is spread from the north to south and east to west. And there are 6 lakh plus villages. And there are different religions, which include 4 major religions and all. So these diversity is an opportunity. The diversity of Indian community, or the way in which the diversity is existing, the way that is catering, and that is offering a wide opportunity for the rural marketing. So why to go to the rural? Because the first reason is high level of saturation is like it is the urban market is already saturated. All the urban people will the market, the all the urban markets are already occupied by the major brands or the major companies or the major entrepreneurs. So almost all it's the saturation level is almost fully attained. Now the rural area is the region where the marketers have just entered, there is less competition and there is huge opportunities. So that's the reason why which we are thinking about this course and why to enter into the rural marketing. So the first thing is high saturation level in the urban areas. Second is greater awareness of brands in the rural area. Nowadays the people living in the rural areas, they are literate enough, they are well educated, they are working, they are traveling to the urban areas, they are shifting to the cities, they are migrating. So they go to know about the big brands. Earlier the rural people used almost all the locally available products and services. They never go and buy for certain brands. But now once their income, the per capita income has increased, the education, they are well educated, they are literate enough, so they came to know about different brands, which are the best brands. So now they are like the greater awareness of the brands are like, now they are aware enough about the different brands. So this awareness is again an opportunity, the reason by which we have to enter into the rural area, and ever growing aspiration in the rural. Third, fourth point is no effects of slowdown in the rural market, because the rural market will be widespread, it is scattered, so there is no chance that in a very near future there the saturation level will be attaining. So there is a wide scope to enter into the market, rural market. Greater opportunities of business, large customer area. As I said, because of its diversity from north to south, it is spread from north to south and east to west. The rural population is widely spread and scattered enough. The customer area is widely spread across. So it offers a great opportunity and low competition. Since only very few companies have started entering into the rural parts like HUL or PNG, started entering into the rural area, started catering the needs and wants of the rural people. So there is very less competition. Now we have understood why we have to enter into the rural marketing or what is the importance of rural marketing. Now we will see what is the definition. Yes, just like marketing, the marketing definition and the rural marketing definition, the whole and soul is almost the same. It is almost the same. But only thing is the end customers is the only, the major difference is the person to whom we are catering or the person to whom we are serving, the one who is availing our services. That is the only difference between rural marketing and the other marketing management. So we'll see the definition. Rural marketing is a process of developing, pricing, promoting and distributing rural specific goods and services, leading to desired exchange with rural customers to satisfy their needs and wants, so and also to achieve organizational objective. The other definition is rural marketing is a marketing for the customers residing in rural area, that is specifically written the customers residing in the rural areas, and it involves designing marketing program to arrive at desired exchange with rural customers that satisfies their needs and want. So what does it say? The definition speaks that it is a process by which the products and services or the commodities are given to we are looking into the customers who are residing in the rural areas. We are catering the needs and wants of the customers in the rural area, and we have to develop certain strategies specific to the rural areas. That is the 4 P's, the product, price, place and promotion, the four P's, that is a marketing mix. So this is the definition of marketing mix. Hope it is understood to you. Now we'll see, what are the characteristic features of rural marketing? Characteristics or features of rural marketing. First point is large and scattered population. As I said, the India is a country of diversity and it is spread across from the north to south and east to west. The population, the villages are scattered enough, the people are scattered enough, and the population, it's a large population, like 74.3% of the people are spread across in India. So it's a major character of rural marketing. So it offers a great opportunity also. Second point is raising prosperity. As the per capita income of the rural people are increasing, they are getting educated, they are earlier they were only involved in the agricultural or allied activities for their income source. The occupation was only agriculture, farming or allied aspects, livestock, poultry and all. But nowadays they are involved in other activities like industries, and they are also working in the service sectors. Also, they have their own businesses and all the different kinds of occupations they are involved into. So their income source is also increasing, their standard of living is also increasing. So this also offers an opportunity. And next is diversity. Next point, growth in consumption. As the population is increasing, the consumption is also increasing. Next point is lifestyle changes. Since they got educated and the income earning, the per capita income earned is also increasing in the rural areas because of the development in the communication, transportation, all the infrastructure facilities in the rural areas are developing. So you can see 10 years back a village in India and right now in 2021, you can see a visible changes available, like infrastructural changes are there, communication level changes are there, transportation changes came. The number of schools and educational facilities or the hospital facilities, all those facilities have been improved in rural areas because of the government initiatives. So this is also a reason by which we have to enter into the rural market. Next is life cycle advantages. And next, market growth rates higher than the urban. Because of the population is large, so growth rate is also larger in rural areas if we compare with the urban areas. Next is rural marketing is not expensive, it is very cheap. Next, remoteness is no longer a problem. And finally, the traditional outlook, if we say, it is a kind of a disadvantage in marketing, rural marketing, because the people in rural areas will be having certain traditional outlooks to certain products and services. So they will not go and get all big branded products, they will always prefer the local brands. That is a traditional outlook. Now we'll see, why so fast growth in the rural area? We have seen in the point when we have seen the characteristic, we have seen there is a larger growth in market growth in urban area if we compare with the rural. Why it is so? So why so fast growth in rural area? The first point is the pro-rural government initiatives and schemes. Yes, we have seen there are many schemes put forward by the government. The Pradhan Mantri Sadak Yojana for the roads transportation, there are many for the communication, there are many for the women entrepreneurs to start, there are startup initiatives are there. For education, there is free educations are there. All those infrastructural facilities, the basic infrastructure facilities are being set up by the government initiatives and schemes. So this is a major reason by which the rural area is developing or it's growing in a very faster rate. Second is rapid rural infrastructure development. We have already discussed 70% of the villages are connected by high quality roads, the transportation. Next, higher awareness through internet connectivity. We have good information and communication facilities. The technological advancement has also been adopted by the rural India. So, because of the connectivity, they are aware about all those things happening in the urban parts of India. good monsoons. So in the rural area, the people will be majorly like their employment is in agriculture and allied activities. So once they have good monsoon, the productivity, the harvest, the yield will be high. So their per capita income increases, which is also a reason for the fast growth of the rural areas. Education, almost all the like the students, the kids in this generation are educated. There is large number of schools built since infrastructural facilities are developing. Large number of schools have been built and basic level of education are offered free education for girls, and till basic education it is also free education. The government have put forward many schemes for that. This is again a reason for the faster growth or development of the rural area. Health services have improved because of many hospitals and health facilities, and like infrastructure, other communication facilities like TV, TVs and internet connectivity is also a reason for which the rural area is growing. Now we'll see what is the difference between the rural and urban marketing. There are certain points on the basis on which we can differentiate the rural and urban marketing. This is very important from the perspective of academics, of the perspective of your exam. So based on the meaning, the urban means higher population and most of the people will be engaged in non-agricultural activities. When it comes to rural, the population will be less. We have seen 400 people per square kilometer. In a square kilometer area, if 400 people, there will be the population density is very less when we compare with the urban area, and the people will be engaged in agriculture activity. Like more than 70% of the people will be engaged in agriculture activity. Then according to the needs, in urban area, the needs, all kind of needs and wants are higher. The level of needs will be higher. When it comes to the rural area, there is a lower level of needs. Literacy, the urban people will be well educated. When it comes to rural market, lower level of education, which is gradually increasing. Adoption of a product. When it comes to purchasing decision of a product, the urban people, it is available to them also, and they are aware enough about the product. So a faster rate of adoption of the product. But for the rural people, they will not, if some new products are launched, that will be launched in the cities or town. So they are not, the products are not available at the same time, they are not aware and they are reluctant to buy certain new products. So very slow adoption of the product. When it comes to the price sensitivity, urban people are not much sensitive to the price, whether it is a high price or low priced, they are okay with the price. But for the rural people, they are price sensitive, they are very much price sensitive. They used to buy like the small quantity and at the same time small priced products. Transportation is very much well developed in urban areas than compared to the rural areas. And distribution, the distribution, if we think from a marketer's perspective, distribution is very much easy and convenient in urban area, but it is very difficult because of the transportation problems in rural area. Even though the roads, almost all the roads, 90% of the roads connectivity we have achieved the road connectivity. Purchasing power. Urban, if you think from purchasing of certain goods or certain products, the urban people, they will the purchasing power, they have a good amount of income, so they can buy anything they want to buy. And for the rural people, it is like they can buy basic things. They give more preference to buying the basic items. Infrastructure is well developed in urban areas or cities. In rural area, it is developing. It is in the urge of developing. It's gradually developing. And the quantity purchased, the urban people, they buy large quantity. And when it comes to rural people, they buy small quantity or small packets, like sachets and all, they used to buy small packets. So this is a major difference between the urban and rural marketing.